They're sleek, sexy, and oh so seductive. Once you've tasted life on board one of these babies, it's hard to go back. Exotic destinations beckon, and you can easily heed their call. Private jets have put the magic back in traveling. Come soar with us on a luxurious journey to uncover the high-flying world of the jet set. People don't plan a trip anymore. It's more like plotting the great escape. Traveling across country can take all day. If you have to make a connection to a smaller airport, this could cost you an extra travel day. More and more people are looking for another way to fly. They're going private.
The airlines have cut back their schedules to a certain extent, so there aren't as many convenient flights. So just as the time required to use the airlines has increased, so has the demand for business aviation increased.
With the private jet industry, sales actually increased between 30 and 100%. And there are a number of reasons. Obviously, safety and security, but also convenience.
Convenience you don't get even if you pay for a first-class ticket. Going first-class won't get you there any sooner. The delays and cancellations are still the same. Successful people are using private jets as a way to enhance their personal lives and move their careers along at jet speed. Professional athletes were among the first to discover the advantages of using a private jet.
One of the real advocates for business aviation is Arnold Palmer, who bought an aircraft and began flying himself. He's a pilot, and he began flying himself from tournament to tournament back in the 1950s. And what he found is he could play a lot more exhibitions, play in a lot more tournaments, arrive a lot more refreshed than trying to drive across the country or work on commercial airlines. So Arnold Palmer credits business aviation with improving his career and his earning potential.
Celebrities like Frank Sinatra and Danny Kaye were the pioneers of private jet travel. Most of these early converts were lured aloft by private jet visionary Bill Lear. His Lear jets gave the jet set wings. Lear's daughter, Shanda, recalls her dad's skill at getting notables hooked on his ideas.
He knew a lot of people in show business, and they loved him because he was a character. He had Irish background, touch of the Blarney Stone, and he could tell stories very well. He was funny. If he had an idea, he could pitch it. And they say entrepreneurs are storytellers. They can pitch their story and convince you of the idea.
Lear pitched his story to his high-flying friends in show business, who became tantalized by his dream of making jets available for private use. But as the commercial passenger jet age dawned, he believed that the really big users for private jets would be corporate executives.
I remember being at the dinner table, and he said, "Kids, Boeing has just flown from Los Angeles to New York in 5 hours in a jet passenger plane. And but executives are not going to want to go in a cattle car, no matter how fast they go. So somebody's going to have to build a small jet for businessmen."
Since no one else was going to do it, Lear said, "I'm going to have to do it." Many didn't believe that Lear's experience as the inventor of the car radio qualified him to build a plane, let alone a whole new class of aircraft. That didn't stop him. By 1962, He had a factory set up in aviation manufacturing heartland, Wichita, Kansas, and a prototype ready to test. The test was a success, but Lear still needed to sell airplanes. His celebrity connections helped to put the Learjet in the public eye. Frank Sinatra wanted to be the West Coast distributor for Lear. Danny Kaye loved his private jet. So did TV host Merv Griffin.
All of these celebrities became just swept up by the enthusiasm because celebrities, as you know, they like to go on their own schedule with their own retinue of people, and they don't really like to be hounded by autograph seekers, et cetera. So it was important for them to be able to travel independently.
Within a short time, Learjets were shuttling the world's most glamorous people to photo shoots and film locations, and even showing up in movies. Now it seems, if you have a name, you have a plane. Like Donald Trump, Mel Gibson, Kevin Costner, and Harrison Ford, just to name a few. The president and editor-in-chief of Elite Travel magazine, Doug Golan, says for high-powered people, buying a commercial first-class ticket is old news.
When you talk about celebrities and athletes and private jets, is really who doesn't. It used to be that if you flew first class, say, New York to Los Angeles, you would see celebrities in the first class cabin. Now the only people you see is people like myself on upgrades.
Celebrities like Tom Cruise and John Travolta have gone one step further. They've earned their pilot's license and own their own planes.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is your captain speaking. Your flying time today will be 2 hours. We are serving lunch, and the movie on board is Grease.
John Travolta bought a vintage Qantas Boeing 707 in 2002. The airline jumped on the PR opportunity, refurbished the plane, gave him a uniform, the title of worldwide ambassador at large, and awarded him official Qantas wings.
There is one important duty that I was asked to perform this morning, and that is to present John with his Qantas wings. Now, I'm presenting this in honor of the fact that John has successfully completed the Qantas Boeing 747-400 first officer simulator training. And I can assure you that is one of the toughest tests any pilot will make or take in this world.
This was one more accomplishment to add to Travolta's long list of planes he could fly. He started very young. As a teenager, he took every paycheck he earned working at a supermarket to pay for flying lessons.
I started flying in 1970 when I was 16 years old. I got my solo in 1974, my license in 78, my jet license in 81, and since then I've logged about 5,000 hours, mostly in jets, and most recently, in my pride of joy, training with Qantas in Sydney, as well as in Boeing in Seattle for this 747 rating.
But we wondered how his fascination with Qantas began.
Qantas always had the biggest mystique for me, the longest overseas routes, the best safety record in history, 82 years of safety, and I've always intrigued by the airline. And then, simply by coincidence, I bought an ex-Qantas 707, which is the one you're filming me on. And they got wind of it when I flew down there to promote Swordfish, and they loved the connection.
Travolta became obsessed with flying. His wife, Kelly Preston, had to put the brakes on.
I have named my son Jet. I wanted to name my daughter Qantas, but my wife put her foot down.
For those lucky enough to go, it was the trip of a lifetime.
First stop is Vancouver, second stop Honolulu, third is Tahiti, then on to New Zealand, then to Sydney, then to Perth and Melbourne, Singapore, Hong Kong, Tokyo, Rome, Paris, London, Ireland, and then to New York is where the tour ends. So I'll see you then.
Besides flying his family on private trips, Travolta uses his planes for business, a practice many high-profile people say is the only way to travel.
This day and age where time is so precious, and all the pressures that you face is in terms of doing things with the time you've got, I mean, it's a no-brainer.
Indianapolis 500 winner and racing team owner Bobby Rahal says he travels to out-of-the-way places and, depending on commercial airlines, is problematic.
Many of the races that we go to are not necessarily in major markets. And particularly with the unreliability of the major airlines, where they seem to cancel flights without a thought, or flights are delayed, or with the hub and spoke, you know, the weather's bad somewhere, you miss your connections, and then you end up missing, you know, you just can't afford to do business that way.
Making connections drives Rahal nuts, especially when the airlines charge top dollar for the inconvenience.
You know, if you're not going hub to hub, you really pay exorbitant airline rates, particularly if you can't plan way in advance. And, you know, so you can, you know, let's face it, instead of driving 3 days to Canada, you're there in 2 hours. And, you know, so you just maximize the time you have.
Time is important to pro golfers, too. Ever since Arnold Palmer led the way, more and more golfers have discovered the joys of private jets.
Number one thing in every golfer's mind, the worst part about our job, and really the only part that we ever complain about, is the travel.
World-class golf pro Jim Furyk claims taking the hassle out of travel gives him an edge.
It's not about saving hours throughout the year, it's about saving days and days and days and even weeks throughout the year. And that, for me, for someone with a family, for someone in any element of business, that time adds up to just an unbelievable amount. And for me, it's definitely helped my career, and hopefully in the future it'll help lengthen my career. Traveling takes its toll, and even in the smallest way, can just pretty much drive you bananas after a while, and hopefully this will give me a peace of mind and help me out in the future.
Reducing the stress of being on the road can mean big wins and big money for athletes. Professional sports teams know they have to have a team plane to stay in the game.
It's probably been at least 15 years since NBA teams and other pro industries have flown any other way. It's been a long time since any of us have been on commercial airlines.
Former Orlando Magic coach and NBA veteran Doc Rivers remembers the days before private jets.
Well, flying commercial was tough. I mean, I kid with some of our younger guys that they have no idea what we had to go through. You know, the NBA rule was you had to take the first flight out of that city that next morning, no matter what time it was. And I remember playing games, you obviously go eat and after a game because you're starving, and you get in your room at 12 or 1, you can't sleep because you're adrenaline, and the wake-up call was at 4.
The Orlando Magic uses a personalized Boeing 737 to take some of the sting out of traveling.
Everybody ready?
Yeah. How are you?
If you go commercial, you always have the chances, even though you've booked up, they'll have a cancellation. It starts backing up. The team winds up getting stranded overnight, laying around in a terminal somewhere, and at least we get them there. We get them there early. And there, we get them there when they want to leave, and we bring them home when they want to come home.
The beauty of flying private for the team starts right when you drive up to the airport.
The team gets to pull into the hangar. They park in there if it's raining. The airplane's in the hangar. They don't get wet. We handle all the bags. We take care of the security. We make sure it's secure on both ends. The bags are taken care of the entire time. And those are things that just don't happen in the other world of aviation.
Ladies.
Hello.
What's going on?
Just like all time, huh?
Yeah. How you doing?
Good. Good.
How you doing?
How's your summer?
Another perk to flying private is the team always has the same flight crew. They make sure these guys feel right at home.
Yeah, yeah, of course. Yeah.
when we do our service, it's really nice because we have the same guys on board all the time, and with the exception for maybe a couple new guests or sponsors that we have on board, but we know every drink that everybody likes. We know what they like to eat, how they like it heated up. We know that Tracy likes tuna sandwiches warm, and we know that Daryl doesn't like any ice in his drinks, and so it, after a couple of years, it's really nice. We even know that, you know, Doc likes decaffeinated coffee with cream and 2 equals. So it's, after a while, it gets just to be, you smile as they come on board and you know exactly what to give them.
Tide is turning towards the Golden State Warriors.
NBA All-Star and coach of the New York Knicks, Isaiah Thomas, says he felt like a kid the first time he flew on a private jet.
Enjoying this one, just as Isaiah Thomas, his first game.
Man, I wish somebody could see me in here. That's how I felt when I got on that jet. I was like, I wish my mom could see me. I got to call up my boys. I got to let people see. So second time I was going to take a ride, I just arranged that, you know, a couple of people was there at the airport, and I was just like, okay, yeah, thanks for dropping me off. I got to go now. I got to get on my plane, go to Chicago. Peace. I'm out.
Thomas was hooked and soon found that having access to a private jet meant he could follow his dreams.
Isaiah's biting his tongue.
You know, I just met Samuel Jackson, you know, and I want to go out to dinner with Sam, but I got to catch this flight. You know, now you can say, okay, Sam, let's go out to dinner. I'm going to call my plane up and say, okay, I'm going to be a little late. And then you own. You know, you get a chance to have dinner. You get a chance to do what you're going to do. And it works. It works for everybody. And it's a very convenient way in those, you know, once-in-a-lifetime moments or opportunities. Now you don't have to pass them up.
You don't have to be a celebrity to benefit from a private jet. Everyone wants more control over their life. A plane that's on your schedule is ideal.
If you finish your business meeting, you finish your vacation, come back to the airport and say, we're now ready to go, the plane takes off. You don't wait around and say, I guess the plane won't be leaving for another 3 hours. Now what do I do?
All that downtime at airports has created a surge for first-time jet customers. Now, more businesses are flying their middle managers on private jets. Companies are becoming more and more sensitive to how all that travel time affects an entire family.
Time is more than money. Time is quality of life. If you can cover your territory and yet get back home on a Friday night to see your son play Little League, that's a quality of life issue.
Well, anyone that's successful in this world, the big shortage they have is time. I mean, they get all the food they need, they get all the clothing they need, they get all the shelter they need, but they don't get all the time they need. And how can you buy time in this world, you know, other than through making travel more efficient?
Billionaire Warren Buffett says his business is his life, and flying private makes life a lot more enjoyable.
I have nothing but fun in my business, and probably the only thing that wasn't so much fun many years ago was the travel part of it. I mean, there were a lot of missed planes or delays and whatever it may be, and a lot of time wasted and a lot of energy expended. But my job is a dream now, and a plane helps in a big way.
People look at it as a perk. One would say it might be a perk, but I look at it as a very effective tool to for successful businessmen to really exceed and succeed at what they're doing. I couldn't do my business without it.
Time is really the most important thing in their lives. These are people that have achieved a lot in life, have accomplished a lot, they're hard chargers, and whether it's business or whether it's pleasure, time is important to them.
When I travel, for instance, I just came back from Europe, well, I spent 6 hours working on the way back, and working with a group of my, you know, executives, where I couldn't do it on an airplane. I mean, we're talking about not only confidential information, but we were spread out on the airplane and we're able to discuss business. And so it gave me 6 hours, no telephones, because again, I could call out, people can't call in, which is a tremendous advantage. And so it's a very effective way to do business.
Flying on a private jet cuts travel time in a number of ways. In many cities, business airports are close to downtown, making it easier to get to a meeting. And there are more airports that a private jet can fly into, which dramatically reduces delays.
There's nearly 10 times the number of business airports that there are commercial airports. As you say, there are about 500 commercial airports in the United States. There are about 5,000 airports that are open to business jets.
There are a number of fixed base operations, or FBOs, around the country that cater to people flying private. These service providers are tailored to meet the needs of private plane users. It's another world compared to a commercial terminal.
Well, I guess anyone can read the papers today, and the lines now are an hour too long and getting into an aircraft. And they give you an awful lot of tough times getting on a regular aircraft.
Peterson's Van Nuys, California FBO offers a very different experience without sacrificing safety or security.
Out here, we pre-screen the people, and we know who's on the aircraft, and we pre-screen, and we check everything. We have very good security, and the people don't have to go through all that hassle.
Peterson's FBO has a tasteful, homey feel, just right for Southern California. It has a pilot's lounge and quarters, a meeting room, weather services, jet sales, aircraft management, charter service, and the list goes on. His wife added the final touch. She furnished the whole place in fine antiques.
Well, when I first started this, my wife said, you know, every FBO I've seen looks terrible. Why don't you do some decorating? And so my wife went out and bought a lot of antiques that matched the California attitude. And I think that's the fun part of our base. It's not just old steel chairs.
Flying privately is an experience that is unforgettable. But it's so much more than just a plane ride. For private jet owners in fractional ownership programs, such as NetJets, it's like being part of a private airline. Inside NetJets Columbus, Ohio Control Center, we found an army of professionals dedicated to scheduling flights, arranging ground transportation, in-flight catering, and even security. No matter where you wanted to go or how complicated your itinerary, they were there to help a customer plan the trip.
From a business point of view, commercial airlines can't compete with what we could offer a businessman. You know, I could be in three cities in one day and be back at night. I've done trips in Europe, 8, 9 cities, 3 days, back in my fourth day. So from a competitive point of view, I get out to see people that probably if I were flying commercial, I wouldn't even go to see.
Our owners, because of the position that they are in life and what they've achieved in their lives, has very high expectations, and that you would expect. So we really work hard to provide them with that exceptional travel experience, that hassle-free travel experience. We try to anticipate things. We try to take one more step than they would expect or do one other thing that they would expect, because those are the things that they appreciate.
The NetJets owner service team uses a sophisticated computer booking system to manage its customers' needs. But the real secret ingredient is the people.
NetJets Flight Center, this is Carmen. Okay, and who am I speaking with?
Our crew wanted to be one of the people on the other end of the line. For just one moment, we could imagine having the ultimate concierge service plan the trip of a lifetime for us.
Okay. Is there anything else I can do for you, Paulette?
There are no lines with us. You know, there is no prepackaged catering. You know, it's all meant just for you and all prepared just for you.
Inside the busy control center, we met a team of professionals, including meteorologists, who track every flight.
What we can do is our licensed dispatchers will take the flight plan and overlay that across the country or the route of flight, and then overlay weather on top of that, and we can see how the flight plan, the actual route that the aircraft's going to fly, interacts with the weather, so that they can then make decisions and provide options to the crews of alternate routing that will ensure that we don't fly through thunderstorms or through bumpy air.
NetJets has a related charter service that offers many of the same conveniences and serves some of the same people.
Typical charter flights are travel for the C-level executives, the CEOs, the CIOs, the CFOs, all those C-level employees of a company, their travel needs, because they are such highly paid individuals, their time is worth a lot of money. The more efficient their time is used, the better.
Using a major charter provider can be a good choice for business travelers who seek to avoid airport delays.
A good charter service will have a variety of aircraft dispersed around the country and around the world. So if you're dealing with a good charter service, you can call and chances are we'll have an aircraft that's in your vicinity that's capable of doing the type of mission that you're looking for. And the good news is that if we don't happen to have an aircraft close by, we can probably find you one.
While a case can be made for chartering a jet or joining a fractional program, experts tell us that cost isn't the best argument.
You're never going to go to a corporate board. You're never going to go to your CPA or your accountant and justify this airplane over commercial first class travel. If it's going to come down to cost, then you're probably not ready to do it.
Commercial will, in 99% of the times, be less expensive. And so you're not talking about this becoming less expensive than commercial. I mean, basically what this does is just changes your life.
The convenience doesn't stop at the tarmac. Inside, the private jet is a whole other experience that once again goes hand in hand with saving time. It's luxury with a purpose. Business jets are designed as an office in the sky. The technology allows instant internet access, satellite phones, fax machines, and TVs that show you where you are every minute of the flight.
The communications on board a lot of business aircraft today are really phenomenal. People can stay in touch with their office, they can talk to markets worldwide, they can talk to others on the airplanes. The people in the business aircraft are facing one another. They can talk about proprietary information without fear of eavesdropping. They can get work done en route. You also have to factor in the productivity gains that you get and the lack of wasted time you have waiting in airlines. And when you put those together, it really makes it very compelling from a business standpoint.
Even though the use of private jets has increased significantly in the last few years, Jack Olcott believes there's still potential for tremendous growth.
It's been estimated that there are over 100,000 companies in the United States that can use this form of transportation. Yet there are only about 10,000 companies in the United States presently using this form of transportation. So the growth potential is quite significant. We did an analysis of 11 companies flying over a four-month period and found that business aviation, compared with the same travel done on the airlines, saved about 6,000 hours of travel not spent. In other words, about 2,600 days were saved. And over 1,500 nights away from home were saved. We call that the divorce factor. Bring people home at night, the family is more satisfied.
Keel Haggerty wanted to put that research to a test. He's the president of a specialty insurance company that caters to classic car and boat collectors across the country. Haggerty wanted to see if he could fly to three sites in one day, mixing business with pleasure. He gathered up a few friends who were also new to the private jet experience. Bombardier's FlexJet program provided a Challenger 604, a crew, food, and all the amenities for our test. They boarded in Los Angeles for the first leg of their trip, up the coast to Monterey.
Welcome aboard the Challenger 604. Looks like we got 39 minutes going over to Monterey. Clear skies all the way, should be a real good flight. TJ over here will take great care of you if you need anything, just let us know.
Thank you.
pick
it. Oh, this is nice.
This is. Here's to work and play.
Cheers. There we go. I'll drink to that. Cheers.
Start. Ignition. 10 stage. Start valve. Ignition. 10.
The interior of the Bombardier Challenger 604 was amazing. And would you believe the seats cost $40,000 each?
This is one of the most comfortable seats I've ever been in, not just on an airplane, but literally anywhere. It's very comfortable. Nice, soft leather, cushy. You sink right into it. Danish.
Well, it's pretty hard to beat it. For one thing, this one is a particularly big private plane, so you can get a number of people in here. You can kind of move people around. We can get to a lot of different places quickly, and I can't think of anything better, really.
I think anybody who'd want to use a private jet is for time. I think people who use a private jet, they have the money, they don't have time. You can always make more money, but you can't make more time. So something like this is a business tool as well as a pleasure craft. Specifically, this type of aircraft, a Challenger 604, very wide, very comfortable. It's a flying living room.
This was an ambitious experiment designed to test whether all the hype about being able to hit three destinations in a day, get some business done, and have some fun was just PR or reality. Within 45 minutes of leaving L.A., the group made their first stop, Pebble Beach.
Oh, that's gorgeous.
Beautiful. A long flight this is another one, aren't
they? Wow. I don't think we're in Kansas anymore, Toto.
After taking in some of the local beauty, Haggerty went to work meeting with potential customers.
Yeah, I was hoping you might be able to tell me a little bit about your car.
Well, it's a 1941 Cadillac 62 convertible, and it's a second owner car. I bought it from the original owner, 93-year-old little fella, and he bought it new in Chicago, and he never abused it. It was always took care of the car. It was really in nice shape when I bought it.
There was something to look at for everyone.
Yeah, I see. There's another one. Yep. There's another one.
Nose.
Aren't they cute?
They're darling.
The rationale of the trip is working for Haggerty. If he'd flown commercially, he'd still be standing in the airport security line. Instead, he was able to meet two customers and then head over to the lodge at Pebble Beach, the site of the world's most elegant car show.
At Pebble Beach, we've been a sponsor for a number of years of the Pebble Beach Concours d'Elegance. This summer, my company is launching a new program for road service for collector cars. And so we're doing a couple of receptions. We're sponsoring some different events. We're going to be sponsoring the tour with flatbed tow trucks all over the place. It's just a lot of sort of advanced work, looked at some locations, kind of made sure that they were very comfortable with what we were doing. And again, we were able to do it in such a short time.
All that work and still time for some fun rides in great classic cars. All too soon, it was time to head back to the plane for the next leg of the trip. The entourage was off to Lake Tahoe, but there's no rush. Haggerty is ahead of schedule. With all the connections, if he'd flown commercially, it would have taken him almost 5 hours to get from Pebble Beach to Tahoe. Instead of having hassles, he's having a blast.
It's fun. That's the best part about it. And you do it because you can and you want to.
I'm totally relaxed. I don't worry about when I get there, and everything's taken care of for me. I like it.
Keep watching this industry. It's growing rapidly, and I think there are going to be a lot more options, both regionally and nationally and internationally, for businesses and individuals. People should keep looking.
Growth is what it's all about, not only for the private jet business, but also for Haggerty's business. His next stop is to meet with customers at Sierra Boats in Lake Tahoe. They are the leading restorers of fine, classic wooden speedboats, especially the Reavers, a favorite toy of playboys on the Riviera.
Sierra Boat is the largest restoration facility for wooden boats in the country, and maybe even the world for that matter, just in terms of square footage. But what you'll see in here is everything from Riva to Chriscraft and Garwood and Hacker. And behind or ahead of McKeel right this minute is a Riva that came into the States about a year ago. Came from Lake Garda. It is what's known as an Ariston. It's about 23 feet long. It is as authentic as they get. It was built in 1961. And you're going to see other examples as well. But this is correct in every way, shape, and form.
After the tour, it's time for the boys from Sierra to show off their toys. One hour after taking off from Monterey, the group was on the water instead of waiting in an airport. Now, is this any way to conduct a business meeting? You betcha. Even after two important business meetings and a lot of adventure, Haggerty and his friends still had time to hit Las Vegas before heading home.
Now we're having fun. We're going to go see some motorcycles at the Guggenheim, then I think we're going to maybe pull some slots and have some fun at the Stardust.
Before they could indulge their desires for wagering, it was time for a little culture. The Solomon R. Guggenheim Foundation moved its most popular exhibit, The Art of the Motorcycle, from its New York museum and set it up in a stunning gallery designed by noted architect Rem Koolhaas. The exhibit was designed by LA architect Frank Gehry. But our crew wanted to get their motors running with a little gaming action. It's so nice to win.
Yes, I won!
I won!
Far too soon, it was time to head off. And if all this excitement wasn't enough, while the happy entourage was away, the flight crew had one more surprise in store for Haggerty and his fiancée, Rebecca.
Oh, my. Hey.
What an ending to this day.
How cute.
Everybody wear your hats.
While he and his friends played, the crew was busy decorating the plane to celebrate her birthday. This doesn't happen on a commercial flight.
I brought you some flowers. I'm part of the crew from Dave and Craig and myself.
Happy birthday and many more. I think it's a lot of fun because then I get to spend my birthday with my fiance, but he gets to do some business at the same time, which is nice for both of us.
Yay! I think I would use one of these things in a way just like today. Today was a great example. We got to go to a couple places that are sort of hard to get to. I got to do some great business. Got to have a little bit of fun.
Haggerty had such a great time and got so much done in that one day, he made some lifestyle changes. He went home, got married, and became an occasional user of private jet charters. While being catered to is part of a fractional owner's program, if you buy your own plane, you'll have to fend for yourself. But not to worry, there are people out there happy to help.
Alicia? How much sugar did you up this to?
If you don't have your own personal caterer or much time to think about it, Sky Meals offers discerning travelers a new way to satisfy their taste buds. Richard Katz, a former TV executive, knew that a scrumptious meal would put anybody in a good mood. He concocted the idea for Sky Meals on a flight home from Paris while eating goodies he'd purchased at a local market.
Sky Meals acts as a personal chef for anybody who is traveling.
Once you've placed your order, Sky Meals chefs fly into action.
This is the most amazing challenge that I can think of in culinary perspective, to design a menu that tastes great cold, that can travel and still be beautiful at a four-star quality is quite a challenge.
We do the shopping, we do the preparation, we do the packaging. So for busy people who are already under a great deal of pressure when it comes to travel by air these days, we try to take a little bit of that pressure away.
We like to talk to each client individually, find out where they're going, if it's a special occasion, and make sure that they're really getting what is going to make their trip the most special to them.
The chefs are willing to fulfill even the most challenging requests. They cater to a demanding clientele.
People who are on diets, who are not on diets, but just, you know, want to eat better food, come to Sky Meals.
Fresh ingredients and personal care helps to make long flights bearable. It beats the stale peanuts served in coach on commercial flights. It even looks better than what's often served in first class.
Always, we try to include things that make the meal beautiful. Edible flowers, mint leaves to make it fragrant, chocolates, candies, little teeny salt and pepper shakers, everything that they would get in a restaurant.
The total experience has broad appeal.
What we found is that it's just about anybody who cares about what they eat. Anybody who isn't willing to settle for the limited choices that you find on an airplane or in an airport.
Eating the right food while in transit, no matter where you're going, can make such a difference.
You don't have to be a private jet user to benefit from their service.
We serve the passenger, whether the passenger flies commercially or privately. We want to cater to the individual. So whatever our customers would like, that's what we'll provide. Whether it's on our menu or something special that's not on our menu or anything in between.
When you're ready to go, you can pick up your luxurious treat on your way to the airport. Or the Sky Meal staff can deliver the meal to your home, office, or even meet you at the curb. Now that you're fed, it's time to roam the globe. Private jet travel puts a new twist on the words freedom, fun, and adventure. Can you imagine jetting off to the Caribbean? Or maybe Cabo San Lucas? How about Telluride, Colorado, without having to make plans months in advance? Private jet providers like Marquee Jets make traveling on a whim more and more inviting. They've joined exclusive resorts in making luxury properties accessible around the world. Joining this club opens the doors on picture postcard settings without the hassles of trying to maintain a second or third home. No effort, no worries, just fun for your family and friends. Imagine coming back to your own lodge at Telluride's Polecat Lane after a long day hiking, biking, or skiing. Settle in for a gourmet meal in an architecturally significant yet comfy log home. An inviting bed beckons as you end the day. But maybe there's time for a little bubbly in the jacuzzi. You may never want to leave. But if you're a member of the club, you'll be tempted to hop on your jet and sample some of the other locations. File a flight plan for New York, and the carriage rides in Central Park and the lights of Times Square can be yours. To paraphrase Sinatra, you'll be part of it all. When it's time to turn in, you'll stay right in the heart of the city, overlooking Central Park. The five-star Trump International Hotel and Tower will provide commanding views of the city. But don't get too settled in. There's still more to see. The plane awaits your command. How about a quick jaunt to sample the sun and sand? It's up to you. The magic of Mexico awaits as you fly into Cabo San Lucas on the southern tip of the Baja Peninsula. In a hidden area, tucked into a quiet bay, you'll discover Punta Ballina. Spas cascade into pools that spill toward the ocean and line the front of your own private villa. Each one has four bedrooms, four and a half baths, gourmet kitchen, and access to the most exquisite grounds imaginable. Paradise can be yours, but why settle for a stationary stay? This time, we suggest you sample life aboard a 644-foot cruise ship, the Residency. When you've had your fill of adventure, call your plane, and you're on your way home again.
If you're out to see the world, you could go to four or five absolutely astounding places in one day where you couldn't do it in a week any other way. You could go to South America, file for a very low altitude, and fly right down the Andes. On a clear, beautiful morning, as the sun came up, it would be spectacular.
If you're going to rent a villa in an upscale Caribbean island, you're able to fly in there nonstop on your private jet. Also a big boon for people who are renting yachts. A lot of times these people who charter yachts are going to go out of one of the Caribbean islands. As opposed to connecting in San Juan or Miami, these people fly nonstop into that Caribbean island on their private jet.
Because private jet travel allows people to live life to the fullest, the industry is enjoying continual growth. The technology and the pioneers on the front lines are creating some incredible flying machines.
The conservative figure is over the next decade, the number of private jets in the world is going to double. The introduction of microjets or mini jets, jets that start at $1 million per jet, if that really fully comes into being, the market for private jets in the next 10 years is going to triple.
Part of that growth is expected to come from a new class of small jets. Companies such as Honda are working to make private jet travel affordable and accessible to more and more people. While it will never replace commercial airline travel, it will become more common.
I would like to make a toast.
And people who have had the private jet experience are diehards. They claim you'll never clip their wings.
You know, it's definitely the best way to go, because when you look at the amount of money that you're going to spend flying commercially, you'll spend about the same amount of money when you do it privately, and you get better convenience and better service. And okay, you get to show off a little bit more too.
Private jets are a symbol of success, fame, opulence, which are all things that everybody wants. And, you know, diamonds, yachts, private jets, those are all the trappings of success and fame and fortune. And everybody wants to be rich and famous.
Well, I love aviation. I love playing anything fast, you know, that kind of figures. I like beautifully built machines. I think the engineering aspects are fascinating. You know, probably if I hadn't have been a race car driver, I would have wanted to have been a fighter pilot or something. And, you know, many, many years ago, I mean, it's just kind of in your blood, I suppose.
The love of flight has been an obsession historically. The love of private jet flight has become an even greater obsession. The speed, the beauty, and the benefits have created a whole new jet set that refuses to settle for anything less.